sir, they are the here in case of parser, the terminals are basically you can say the identifiers and keywords. Then what other thing? Operators, right? So all these things can be the terminal here. And non-terminals are which are possible to expand further, okay, drive further. Okay, so in general, in standard form, we write the non-terminals as the capital letters, using the capital letters like A, B, up to Z. Okay, and in formal on a write formally, the terminals are is usually given by small letters. Okay, then there should be start symbol. Most of the cases give it by S, but it can be anything else. It can be anything else. Okay, but you have to define what is the start symbol for your grammar. Then there should be some set of production rule. So a non-terminal called ahead or left side of the production when if you have something like this A to alpha, then we'll call this non-terminal is a head, and this a body on the right side constituting of zero or more terminals and non-terminals. So that is the reason I have written alpha. This is called body. It can be combination of terminals and non-terminals. Okay, so this is what grammar rules looks like. Okay, so if you look at this, can you tell me what are the terminals and what are the non-terminals available here? In the chat box, you can write down. In this given grammar, what are the terminal and what are the non-terminals? Can you identify? Okay, Rishabh given some answer. Now, do you have if here? You don't have if, right? I don't see if here. Okay, I think he answered for the previous grammar. Actually, there is a delay between my slide change and when it is going to display on your screen. Quite a big delay is there. So for this grammar, can you tell me what are the terminals, what are the non-terminals, and start symbols? Nobody is giving any answer. So at least terminus you can just write down here. Are you answering anybody? Okay, so as I can see, nobody is answering. Okay, so what are the terminals are here? As I have told you, all the identifiers are terminals. So ID is one terminal. Here we have opening bracket, we have closing bracket, and we have arithmetic operators like plus, minus, multiplication, division. Okay, so these are the terminal. What are the non-terminals are there? Expression is non-terminal, then term is non-terminal, factor is non-terminal. Okay. Then any other non-terminal? Can you see? I can see only these three non-terminals are there. Then what is start symbol here? Start symbol here is expression. Okay. So this is what about this representative grammar. And this same grammar you will find many times while writing like this. So these expressions are written as E, terms are written as T, and factors are written as F, right? So the same grammar can many times you write in short like this. Okay. Now, inherently recursive structure of programming languages are defined by context-free grammar. Why it is saying that it is recursive structure? You will find in a program, basically, very few syntax are there, and most of the instruction we are writing in a source code, their structure are similar. Okay, so they are recursive. The structure are kind of recursively arriving. Then, in contextual grammar, we have a finite set of terminals, a finite set of non-terminals, okay, and a finite set of production rules in the following form A to alpha, where A is a non-terminal and alpha is a string of terminal and non-terminal, including the empty string. So alpha can represent, can be epsilon or empty string as well. And it must have a start symbol defined, okay, one of non-terminal symbol. Okay, so this start symbol is a member of the non-terminal. Okay, so here we have an example grammar you can see, and here E is start symbol, and okay, E is start symbol, and else other are you can see only everywhere it is E, and you can see this grammar. Okay, this is a grammar can be used to evaluate arithmetic expressions, simple arithmetic expressions. Okay, then derivation. So what is derivation? If you have something, some grammar rule like E to E plus, sorry, E plus E. Okay, then you can, in general, you can write it like this, or you can, many times we do it like this, E plus E. But this is derivation, and this is called derivation tree. Okay. So E plus E derived from E here, we can replace E by E plus E. This is the concept or derivation. Okay, to able to do this, we have to have production rule e to e plus e in a gram, then only you can do this. Okay, e to e plus, then if we have e to id, then in one move we can replace this first e by using e to id. Okay, and next time this e by using again e to id. Okay, so a sequence of replacement of non-terminal symbols is called derivation of id plus id from e. Okay, so in general, the a derivation step is it is delayed, the delay is too much. So in general, a derivation step is looks like this. You know, we had a here, this a is can see replaced by gamma. So if there is a production rule a to gamma in our grammar, where alpha beta are arbitrary string terminal and non-terminal symbols. So alpha and beta here can be arbitrary strings of terminals and non-terminals, right? So you can see here how the derivation looks like. So alpha n is derived from a1 and so on. You can see this. So here is the symbols we use to represent derivation. You can see here this arrow is representing drives in one step. This arrow represents drive in zero or more steps. And this, if you have plus, then it means drives in one or more steps. Okay. Then some terminology. L of G is the language of G, okay, which is a set of sentences. So a sentence of LG is a string of terminal symbols of G. Now if S is the start symbol of the grammar G, then omega is sentence of LG if and only if S can drive omega in, because see here star is there, that means S can drive omega in zero or more steps of derivations, right? Where omega is string of terminal of G. Now a sentence of G is a sentinel form with no non-terminal. Okay, when we call a sentence when there is no terminal but it is in a sentinel form. Okay, now CFG terminology is again is somewhat more. If G is a context-free grammar, then LG is also context-free language. Two grammars are equivalent if they produce the same language. Now, if you have, if S drives alpha, and if alpha, no, if drives alpha, when, or if alpha contains non-terminal, it is called a sentinel form. So when we call this alpha is the sentinel form if there is only non-terminals. Okay, and if alpha does not contain non-terminals, it is called a sentence. So you understand what is sentence and sentinel. If alpha does not contain non-terminal, it is called as a sentence. And if alpha contain non-terminal, it is called as sorry, it is I have written wrong. If alpha contains non-terminal, it is called as sentinel form of G. Okay. So here you can see to the example.